there is never, you know, one idea or one theme or something. You know, I always has some variation of thoughts or ideas in my mind. But I think that if I had to summarize that, maybe to write about how hard it can be to exist today. I mean, how far away we are sometimes from our roots. I mean, we are so full of stress and working so hard. I mean, in the older days, people was very, the body was very getting fast, very old in fast way because of hard work. But now it's getting old because of stress. So I thought it's very curious that how you know, technology and new things should make us our life easier, but in a way it's making our life more difficult, more full of stress. And I found it rather curious, so I wanted to write about it. But when I start with the book, then I realize that I also have to find, to understand the situation we are today, I have to go to the past and look how things, you know, were then and how they changed or didn't change in the while the time was well, you know, when people 100 years ago, people didn't have so much choice in life. They didn't have a choice of education, or only if you were very clever or very rich. Usually you'd have only one or two paths to follow. So there was no, you couldn't choose. They were chosen for you before you were born. Today, we are facing 100 paths. You have to choose by yourself. And that's the agony of our life today. And I found that curious, and that's part of how difficult it is to exist today, to choose your own path. Yes, that was one of my intention to write about that. But it's one thing to decide to write about something, then you start to write, and then something very unexpected pops up. So usually I end up with books that I didn't plan to write. It just appears to me. A book sometimes writes itself, in a way. Always had trouble with to explain what my books are about. And it worried me first when I was starting as a writer. But then I realized that other people had also trouble with telling what my books are about. And that was a relief. And I discovered that the story itself is not the main. Of course, it's important. The story is important, and what is happening in the book. But other things are also important. The language, the style, the details in the style, the details who are the big and small thoughts that lies between the lines. I tend to believe that of course it can be totally wrong, but if you can easily tell what the book is about in a few lines, there is, why bother to read it? My biggest worry is that I would panic. There are so many books that I want to save, that in the end I will not be able to save one book, and I will burn off myself because I couldn't choose.